In limbic system, you have to cover the following points: introduction, unique characteristic feature, physiological anatomy, the connections of the limbic system, physiological functions, and the applied aspect of it. Now, another name of this limbic system is rhinencephalon. The meaning of limbic, it is border or the ring. The structures include two, the limbic cortex and the subcortical structures. And it is responsible for the emotions and the behavior. So the chief function or the main function of the limbic system is emotions and the behavior related with the emotions. So the after introduction, there is a unique, we will see the unique characteristic feature of the limbic system. So there are two features of the limbic system. One is it has a very few connections with the neocortex. So you cannot make your emotions turn on or off at your own will. Suppose some emotional experience you have, then you cannot immediately turn it off or on at your own will. That is because there is a very few connections with the neocortex. But neocortex can modify the emotions. So that is the first characteristic. Now the second characteristic is prolonged after discharge. The second property, that is the prolonged after discharge. This prolonged after discharge, it is responsible for the emotional emotions response continue long after even the end of the stimuli. So there are two property. One is few connections with neocortex, and the second one is the prolonged after discharge. So here it is a physiological anatomy of the limbic system. In the dark pink area, it shows the cortical structures of the limbic system, that is of the limbic cortex. And in the boxes that are in the light pink area, they shows the subcortical structures. So cortical structures are the orbitofrontal cortex, subcallosal gyrus, cingulate gyrus, parahippocampal gyrus, and the uncus. The structures which are written in the boxes, that are the subcortical structures, and that are septum area, paraolfactory area, anterior nucleus of thalamus, hypothalamus, amygdala, portion of basal ganglia, and the hippocampus. Now the connections of the limbic system. So the bundle of the axons connecting the various components of limbic system are here. The one is the fornix, the second one is mammalothalamic tract, the third one is terminalis, the striate medullaris thalami, and the medial forebrain bundle. Among this medial forebrain bundle, it is a very important, it is a major bundle of axons that connects the limbic system with the other parts of the brain. So don't forget medial forebrain bundle. Now the Papez circuit. This Papez circuit, it is a closed circuit formed by the connections between the cingulate gyrus, hippocampus, mammillary bodies, and the anterior nucleus of the thalamus. This circuit is very important because it is responsible for the resting EEG during the sleep. And the second, it is important for those emotions and the aspects of behavior which are specific to individual and the specific to species. Now we will move to the efferent connections. This is a diagram showing the efferent projections of the limbic system. You can see the efferent projection is mainly through the hypothalamus. You can also see that the all four structures of the Papez circuit, they are has a very much role in the efferent projections of the limbic system. Through hypothalamus, they influence the autonomic centers, and amygdala and the hippocampus, they also affect the bulbar reticular formation. Here it is a list of the functions of the limbic system. This physiology of emotions, motivational behavior, autonomic functions, feeding behavior and regulation, sexual and the reproduction behavior, and the last one is the maternal behavior. Then physiology of emotions, you have to remember the definition of emotion, what is behavior, and you can explain the physiology of emotions by the concept of the extended Papez circuit, neuronal activities of the extended Papez circuit. So the emotions is, it is a aroused state involving the intense feeling, autonomic activation, and the related behavior which accompany many of our conscious experiences. And behavior, it is considered an expression of the emotions. And this emotions physiology, you can explain by the neuronal activities of extended Papez circuit. We can explain the genesis of emotion by the neuronal activity in the external Papez circuit. Compare this external Papez circuit with that of the Papez circuit. You will found that there is an addition of the amygdala in between the hippocampus and the hypothalamus. Remember or the recall the Papez circuit in which there is four structures, cingulate gyrus, anterior thalamus, mammillary bodies. Here we write the hypothalamus instead of this mammillary bodies and the hippocampus. That are the part of the Papez circuit, and here there is an addition of the amygdala. You can see the sensory input or the input to for this Papez circuit. It is from the association cortex, which do the functions of interpretation of the information. So the association cortex gave the input to the hippocampus, and it also gives the information to the cingulate gyrus, particularly through prefrontal cortex. So you can remember the association cortex gave the information to the cingulate gyrus where the emotional flavor is added, and information is remain circulated in the extended Papez circuit, and the emotions can generate it. Another sensory input, it is from the environment, it go to the sensory thalamic input, and from that it go to the hypothalamus. The final efferent connection or projections, it is through the hypothalamus, it goes to the brainstem. From brainstem, there is a connection to the spinal cord and autonomic centers. In that way, emotion and behavior is regulated. This is the motivational physiology. Here we will remember the reward centers and the punishment centers. For the reward centers, the lateral hypothalamus with weak stimuli will act as a reward centers. While ventromedial nucleus of hypothalamus, it is also the reward center. The less potent area which act as a reward center, that the part of amygdala, portion of basal ganglia and the septum area. Now there is a list of the punishment centers, the periventricular zone of thalamus and the hypothalamus, and the area surrounding the aqueduct of sylvius in the midbrain will act as the punishment centers. Other less potent punishment area are hippocampus and the amygdala. Thus reward and the punishment centers, they actually motivational physiology, they form the basis of the learning and the basis of the memory. The autonomic functions, they are all through the hypothalamus, cardiovascular regulation, gastrointestinal regulation and the respiratory regulation. The next function is the feeding behavior regulation. It is also through the lateral hypothalamus, in which there is a lateral hypothalamus. It will act as a center for hunger and the thirst. While ventromedial hypothalamus, it will act as a center for the satiety. It will decrease the food intake, and it will create the tranquilizer type of feeling, the feeling of complete relaxation. It is also the reward center. The sexual and the reproduction behavior, there are two components. One is the neural control and the another one is the endocrinal control. Neural control, you have to remember the three structures. One is the neocortex and the limbic cortex. They are responsible for the partner seeking behavior and urge to copulate. When we remove this neocortex or the limbic cortex in female, there is a absence of the sexual drive. Then piriform cortex overlying the amygdala, they inhibit the sex drive in the male. The most anterior and the most posterior part of the hypothalamus, they are responsible for the sexual behavior in both in male as well as in the female. Endocrinal control of the sexual and the reproduction behavior, it is mainly through the gonadotropins, and these gonadotropins, they are under the control of GnRH, and the GnRH, they are released from the hypothalamus. Now the next, it is a maternal behavior. The maternal behavior, it is related to the breastfeeding and the protection of the offspring. The cingulate gyrus of the limbic system, it is responsible for this maternal behavior, other than the hormones such as prolactin and the oxytocin. Now the next point, it is the important role of different components of the limbic system. First we talk about the hippocampus. Peculiarity of hippocampus, it is the hyperexcitable. It is a critical decision making neuronal mechanism. It will decide that the importance of the sensory signal and decide accordingly that it should be converted into the long-term memory or not.
Next one is the amygdala. It has a two part. One is the corticomedial and the another one is the basolateral. The corticomedial part, it has a function associated with the olfaction. This basolateral part is well developed in the human being. And it is important for the all behavior. And it also acts as a window through which the limbic system sees the place of the person in the world. So the behavior awareness areas present in the amygdala, they operate at the subconscious level and they observe that the behavior is appropriate for occasion or not. The areas of the hypothalamus associated with the behavior control are this, and the recall the function of that area, the lateral hypothalamus, it will act as a reward center as well as it is responsible for the thirst and the hunger. The ventromedial nucleus, it is responsible for the satiety center and the reward center. The next is the periventricular zone of the hypothalamus, that is the punishment center. And the most anterior and the most posterior part of the hypothalamus, they are do the function of sexual behavior in male and in the female. The limbic cortex of the limbic system, it will be act as an association area for the control of the behavior. The anterior temporal cortex, it will do the function of the taste and the olfactory association. The parahippocampal gyrus will do the auditory association and the complex thought association. The posterior cingulate cortex, it will do the function of the sensory motor association. And as an applied part of the limbic system, there are two. One is the Clover-Bussy syndrome and the second one is the anterograde amnesia. The first, we talk about the Clover-Bussy syndrome. There is a bilateral destruction of the amygdala or the removal of the anterior part of the temporal lobe. It will be characterized by the loss of the fear, the extreme orality, that means excessive tendency to examine the objects orally, the extreme curiosity about everything, and the last one is the excessive sexual drive. The second one is the anterograde amnesia, in which if the portion of the hippocampus is removed, the person cannot retrieve or cannot learn the new information based on the verbal symbolism. So person can recall the past information and the experiences, but he cannot learn the new things. It is because there is a important role of hippocampus, that the conversion of the information into the long-term memory. That is because of that. If you remember the Gajini movie of Amir Khan, in that movie, the Amir Khan has an anterograde amnesia.